how many of you are going to read it, and that we'll all be there together.
我们都会与主一同在新天新地里面。
Ever and ever.
到永永远远。
Amen.
Amen.
Meanwhile, I want to give you the reasons from the New Testament why I cannot believe that applies to me now.
那为什么我现在用新约的例子告诉你们，为什么我是不相信现在的我是一次得救永远得救？
First, there is the amazing balance in Scripture.
第一，在圣经里面有很平衡的教导。
Between God's ability to keep me,
讲到神他的能可以持守我。
And my responsibility to let him.
还有我自己的责任，我要允许他来持守我。
Take the little letter of Jude.
我们来谈犹大书里面所讲到的。
It finishes with a lovely benediction.
犹大书最后的结束是一个非常美的颂赞。
May the God who is able to keep us from falling.
那能保守你们不失脚。
And present us.Faultless before His throne of grace,
叫你们无瑕无疵，欢欢喜喜站在他荣耀之前。
God is able to do both those things.
神可以做这两件事哦。
He is able to keep you from falling.
他可以保守你们不失脚。
And present you faultless,
然后让你无瑕无疵的出现在他面前。
And that verse is often quoted in church.
我们常常在教会里面引用这个经文。
But just before it is another verse.
但在这之前还有另外一个经文哦。
Keep yourselves in the love of God.
你要持守自己在神的爱中，保守自己藏在神的爱中。
Do you notice the combination?
你看到这两个配合吗
？Keep yourselves in His love.
第一，你要保守自己藏在神的爱中。
And the God who is able to keep you from falling.
那人保守你们不失脚的神
There are two sides to being kept
要在神的保守的里面是有两个方面的哦
God's ability and your responsibility
神保可以保守你的能力还有你自己持守在保守的责任
Take Paul's letter to Timothy
我们来看保罗在提摩太书对提摩太所吩咐的
In one part he says He is able to keepWhat I've committed to him against that day.
他说他能够持守我教训他我吩咐他的直到那日
Turn over the page.
但是你下一页怎么说呢
And he says I have kept the faith.
他说所信的道我已经守住了
You stay saved by the God who is able to keep and by keeping yourself.
那你怎么样能够持守在这个救赎的里面因着神他可以托住你持守你同时你也守住所信的道
You go on trusting God and he will keep you
你继续的信赖他他会保守你的
Keep yourself in his love and he is able to present you faultless
你保守在他的爱的里面他可以使你无瑕无疵的站在他面前
On an earlier evening I quoted Romans 8
在之前我讲到罗马书第八章十一节
At the end of Romans 8,
在罗马书第八章跟第十
Neither death nor life
他说无论是死是生
Nor angels nor principalities nor powers
是天使是掌权的是有能的
Nor things present nor things to come
是现在的事是将来的事
Nothing in the height or the depth
是高处的
Is able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus.
都不能叫我们与神的爱隔绝，这爱是在我们主基督耶稣里的。
Many people cling to that as a promise.
很多人抓住这个经文，成为他们生命的应许。
But the list does not include yourself.
但是这个经文其实不包含了我们自己。
You're the only person who can separate you from the love of God.
这里面没有说到的是你，你是唯一可以让你自己与基督的爱隔绝的。
Nobody else can.
没有任何人可以。
Nothing else can.
没有任何的人事物可以。
Jesus has said, "No one shall pluck them out of my hand."
耶稣说，没有人可以从我手中把他们夺走。
But he didn't say, "You can't jump out of my hand."
可是他却没有说，你不能够从我手中跳走。
In fact, in John 15, Jesus says, "Abide in me."
甚至在约翰福音第十五章，他说：“你们常在我里面
，stay in me，
就是停留在我的里面。
Because the branch doesn't bear life in itself.
因为枝子本身没有那个生命的养分。
It lives on the life of the vine.
那个枝子是活出那个葡萄树的养分。
And Jesus is the true vine.
而耶稣是真葡萄树。
If you stay in him, you have eternal life.
如果你住在他的里面，你就会有永生。
If you cut yourself off from him, you lose your life.
如果你跟他隔离的话，你会失去生命的。
Because as John says in his letter,
因为约翰在他的书信当中告诉我们说
this life is in his son.
这个永生是在他的儿子里面的。
Whoever goes on in the son goes on having life.
那个继续持守在他儿子里的就继续持守在生命里。
You don't have eternal life in yourself.
在你自己里面没有永恒的生命。
You've got it in Christ.
你是在基督里得着这个永恒的生命。
And Christ himself says, as long as you stay in me, you'll be fruitful, you'll have life.
基督自己也说，你只要常在我的里面，你就会有生命，而且会多结果实。
But if a branch doesn't stay in me,
如果一个枝子不在我的里面。
It will stop bearing fruit.
它会停止结果子。
It will lose its life.
它会失去它的生命。
It will wither and die.
它会枯干，会死去。
And be thrown into the fire.
然后被丢在火里烧。
While we're on that,
当我们讲到这个的时候
I wrote that book on hell.
我写那个通往地狱的不归路。
And pointed out that all Jesus' warnings about hell.
讲到所有耶稣提醒我们关于地狱的
except two
只有两个
were given to born again believers
只有两个是给予重生得救的基督徒的
that's why I fear finishing up in hell
这是为什么我会害怕最后的结束是在地狱里
having preached to others
就是已经向别人传福音
be disqualified myself
就自己却没有得着
Paul feared that.
这是保罗的害怕。
So do I.
而我自己也有这样的害怕。
This doesn't mean I become neurotic.
这不代表我变得非常紧张兮兮的基督徒。
I don't wake up every morning wondering if I'm a Christian.
我不是每天早上起来在想我还是不是基督徒。
But I fear the Lord.
但是我有一个敬畏神的心。
And I fear finishing up in hell.
那我也有一个害怕是我不要在最后结束的时候到地狱里面。
Because of all these passages.
因为这些我们刚才所提到的这些的经文。
If you read Hebrews, there are some very severe warnings.
在希伯来书里面其实有非常多的严厉的提醒。
Chapter 6 is well known.
希伯来书第六章是我们很熟悉的。
But chapter 10 is not.
但是希伯来书第十章是我们比较常忽略的。
And in chapter 10, the writer says this.
在希伯来书第十章那个作者这样说。
That if we deliberately and willfully go on sinning after we've come to a knowledge of the truth,
就是当我们已经认识真道，却仍然在罪中的话，
there is no more sacrifice for sin,
就不再有任何的罪祭。
The cross can't help you now.
那个时候十架也没有办法帮助你。
And it ends, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God.
他最后结束的时候，我们在那个神的手中，这样子说话是非常可怕的。